We've had a bit blues, baby. Come in a bit nearer.
Make up your mind.
Hey?
Make up your mind. In, out, in, out.
In, out, shake it all about. Baby, what are we doing today then?
Yankee cookie and just turn around.
That's what it's all about. We are going to make a lovely old dish, which I love it, Sharon.
Macaroni cheese.
Mac and cheese, Sharon.
I add things to it.
The Americans call it mac and cheese. Is it the same thing?
No, because this is Sharon's macaroni cheese.
Right, let's get going, baby.
We've added extras.
Get your tools out. Right, so, right, we're going to do some mac and cheese, baby. We're
going to do... Be careful.
On that. Oh, this one's on, is it?
Yeah. That's getting the water ready to put the macaroni in.
Right, well, I'll put that back over there then, shall I? What do I pull that over here for? So first of all, folks, we're going to make mac and cheese, macaroni cheese, call it what you want. Normally made with, what is it? Just cheese?
I'll pass you the things over, Sean, what it's normally made with, so you can shape it.
Macaroni? I thought you had all this ready, baby.
I have prepared it all.
She's crawling around the back of the camera there, folks.
There's your cheese.
Right, so let's have a look at the ingredients now. Oh, look at that, baby. You've suddenly got all the ingredients in front of you.
That's magic.
Magic. Right, let's have a look and see what we got here. So what we got, baby?
350 grams of cheese.
Yep.
One onion.
Yep.
One leek. 200 grams of chopped bacon pieces. And 500 grams of macaroni. Milk and a flour. Flour.
Where's the flour, baby?
I forgot the flour.
She's forgot the flour, folks.
I forgot the flour.
She forgot the flour, folks.
I'm only human.
How much flour do we need?
About...
You're going to guesstimate it, aren't you?
All this I usually make off my head. It's been very hard for me today to measure things out.
Yeah.
It's a thing that I make a lot, so I just know.
She just knows, baby.
I just know.
You just know, don't you?
I do.
Right, so where do we start? Right, so you've got your little frying pan now, baby.
Yep.
What are you going to do now, then?
Put me bacon in, me leeks and me onions.
So you're just going to pre-cook these before you actually put it all together, is that
That's right?
That's right,
yeah.
So in with the leeks, in with the onions.
Let me just let that...
And that will just cook down.
Yeah, it'll just get a bit softer.
Right. While she's doing that, while that's heating up, the water's bubbling now, folks, as you can see.
I always put in a dash of oil.
Right.
Because it hopefully usually helps stop the pasta from sticking together.
There's a little tip for you, folks. So we're just going to whack that in there now. And put the lid on. It cooks quicker, folks, when you put the lid on. So that's just starting to sizzle away now, folks. So she'll brown this off and wilt them leeks and onions down. And then we'll come back to you. Right, folks, you've been cooking that for about 5 or 10 minutes now. And just keep moving it about. It's not burnt at all. Let's show you. Just all the liquids evaporated away there, and the onions and leeks are just nice and soft now. So the macaroni now is now done. It's not totally soft. There's still a little bit of bite. Baby, try one of them. See if that's done.
Done.
Yeah? Just a little bit of a bite to it, isn't it?
Yeah, it's soft.
Oh, is it?
Yeah, soft.
Oh, okay. Right, so what do we do now then?
Drain these and put this in this bowl with the macaroni, then we're going to mix together. So I'll go and drain these.
So all she's going to do, folks, is just literally pour that through a colander.
And you see, nothing, well, I say nothing stuck. Always get one.
One little one, baby.
You get one, and that is the oil.
There you go. So just shake it off, keep that in there, and that's just going to go over now.
I always put stuff in the bowl so everything gets combined.
So you're just going to whack this in a big mixing bowl first of all, then.
Yeah, just get it all mixed together.
Yeah. In with our leeks and bacon and onions. All goes in, as you say, nothing's coloured, folks, so, but it is all cooked through. It's what you call wilted, Sharon. Soft.
Right there.
Right, get your macaroni, folks. Just whack that in there.
I'll put some seasoning in.
So a little bit of salt. We use the old Himalayan sea salt, folks.
That's the rock version.
A little bit of the old ground black pepper. We like plenty of that. Always put plenty of that in, folks. There we go. And just incorporate all them ingredients in there. We haven't finished with this yet, folks, because we've still got to put the
sauce,
the cheese sauce in, and also the cheese, but we're just giving it a head start.
The cheese sauce is the cheese. Right? It's the cheese sauce and the cheese.
Well,
the cheese.
You know what I mean, baby.
Right, I'm going to put these into two containers.
Why two?
One's going to be for the oven. and one is for the air fryer.
So we're actually doing a little test here, folks. We're going to be doing one portion in the oven the standard way, and we've never done one in the air fryer before.
I made this so I can lift it out of the air fryer.
Brilliant, good idea. Go on, and off you go. And just a portion for the air fryer. There you go, look at that look. Doesn't it look lovely? Get all them leeks off the side, baby.
I will.
All them onions, I want everything in there. Nothing goes to waste in this house. Right, so we've got our two bowls. That one's going to be going in the oven, folks. And this one here, the smaller one, we're going to be putting in the air fryer. So all we're going to do now is make the sauce now, the cheesy, lovely goodness sauce, baby, that goes over the top of that. So how are we going to do that?
2 pints of milk. I don't make a roux like a lot of people. This is the way my mum used to do it.
And it works perfectly, baby, doesn't it?
Well, I've always done it. And I think with that, see, it's all guesswork. 1, 2, 3.
3 dessert spoons, just to start you off with, to get it going. And you're just going to give that a little whisk.
Keep whisking it all the time, so you get no lumps.
Until it gets a bit hot.
It will start to thicken up. Once, no lumps. And then when you feel the thickness, then you will start adding the cheese.
So we'll bring this up to the boil. Then we'll start to add the cheese. And then she'll pour this over the pair of them two. And then they can go in the oven. So there you go, folks. That's our cheesy sauce now made. Now, she's not put all the cheese in. She's kept a little bit back because we're going to sprinkle that over the top when we finish. So there you go. And as you can see, it's a lovely smooth sauce there. No lumps, no nothing. So just do it the way we've done it and you won't go far wrong. And all we're going to do now is literally just pour this sauce over the top of that mixture we got there. Go on, baby. Oh, look at that. Go on, whack it in there, baby. Lovely, and she'll give this a little stir up in a minute.
Yep.
And she'll try and distribute all that bacon and leeks all the way through evenly so that everybody gets a little bit. There you go.
And we'll just put the last bit on this because it's bigger.
Yeah, whack it in there, baby, just to finish off. Don't want to waste none of that goodness, baby. Right, so once you've done that, all she'll take is a little bit of grated cheese there, what we had left, and just put a little bit of a sprinkle over the top there, folks.
I usually do it when it's cooler.
There we go. So this one, the big one, is going in the standard oven, folks. Just put that in there in the middle shelf. So how long is that going in for, baby?
180 centigrade, and I will leave that in until the top starts going brown and bubbling.
So you basically just got to keep an eye on it.
Yeah.
Could be half hour?
Could be. Right. Yeah, about that, I suppose.
And this one, folks, is going to go in the air fryer.
Yeah.
So again, we've never cooked this before in an air fryer. We don't know what it's going to go like, but that's what she's done with that silver foil handle there. Look, just goes in there lovely like that.
You see, it's a tight fit, so I thought we've got something to grab hold of.
Of course you have. Can't have got something to grab hold of, baby. So put that in there.
We go air fry, I think we go temperature 160.
Right.
Let's try, we'll try 18 minutes.
We'll try 18 minutes.
But we will keep checking because I don't know, I've never done it on here before.
Here they are, folks. They're both out of the oven. We'll have a closer look at them in a second, but all I'll say is, how long did the one in the air fryer take, baby?
10 minutes.
10 minutes. And this one took in the oven?
25.
25 minutes, folks. Let's have a closer look at them. Come on in, baby, dig it out. We've had a little dig in there already, folks, as you can see, but look at that. Oh.
You want a bit of the other one as well?
Yeah, get a bit of the other one out as well. Let's have a little go at the other one. Look at it, look. Bit of that crusty top, baby. There you go, folks. She said, is it going to be better than that, folks? I would imagine so, baby. Put that away. Right, go on in. Tell me what you think of it. You have a go first.
So that's my usual standard, very good.
I'll tell you what I'm going to do, folks. I do like a bit of cheeky black pepper. Go on, go on, I'll pop it on mine as well, baby. You always got to have a bit of extra black pepper on. Come on, baby. Has that made it any better?
Mm.
Yeah?
We're pepper junkies though, aren't we?
Yeah, let me have a go now. Mm. Oh, you beauty. I've been looking forward to this. I want to get a bit of that bacon on there as well, baby. I like a bit of everything. Here we go.
It's not my fault. You've been lying, saying that I took away your peace. Drowning by yourself,
you know, don't
want to blame me.
Like you, oh, Sharon. Options, that is absolutely options. Superb.
No, I'm not the problem. Man, that's on
you. Oh, my God. And you know what's happened? What we said was going to happen? That cheesy sauce has worked its way into the little flutes. Them little tubes are full up with it, baby. And the leeks are bringing something to the party which I never expected. An oniony taste, it's like an onion field.
I will say, chilies are nice in it.
I feel like I'm running through a field of onions, baby. The bacon, it brings such a salty touch to it. I feel like I'm on the beach, Sharon. I feel like with all that salt, I feel like I'm cascading in the salty brine while I'm eating this macaroni cheese, baby. Mm. Hold me up, girl. Oh, I bet you're a lot of energy.
You're lucky to have a wife that's a good cook, aren't you?
And a good one that can hold me up as well, baby. Well, folks, you've got to try that.
It's very simple.
Simple ingredients again.
Simple dinner.
And there's no specifics. She didn't measure half of that stuff normally.
100 times better than this. I called
it. Oh, that's a
food.
Sharon. See that? That is now a doorstop. Put it down there, baby. Hold that door open with it.
There's a dog there. There you have it.
Right, folks. Well, have you seen what we've done here? It's a fantastic meal. And as I said to you before, we're learning with the air fryer, aren't we?
Yeah.
We've never done that in the air fryer before, and that took 10 minutes. I know it was all pre-cooked, but it's got that golden glistening on the top. Let's show you it again. That was the one, as I said, that's in the oven. And there, the cheese, that does help putting, oh, that's my shadow. And that does help putting that cheese on there, folks. But can you see how it's all browned off lovely on the top of that one as well? That's all right, but that probably cost us a lot more in energy to cook, baby.
Yeah, yeah, would have done.
I know it's a smaller bowl, but we could have done two lots in there, couldn't we?
Yeah, these bowls are ideal. If anybody asked me where I got these bowls from, I got these years ago, and they were from IKEA.
See how the camera's here, baby.
I'm not doing it again, I'm talking to that tripod.
Don't talk to the tripod, baby.
These bowls here are from IKEA, and they do have plastic lids to go with them, and I think they were £5 each. So if you want to go on the IKEA website and look for them, they fit in the Ninja drawer perfectly.
That's superb. I could eat a whole tray of that, yeah.
I know you could, that's why I'm moving it away.
Well, don't forget, folks, check out our other videos, our other food playlist. Oh, I must stop with talking with my mouth full,
yeah,
baby.
It's very rude.
Anyway, thanks very much, folks. We'll see you in the next video, and until then,
bye-bye.
Bye for now.
Like, subscribe,
share. Oh, you want me to do your fun then, baby? I need to took a bite out of it.